Welcome back to my channel. Today we're diving into the thrilling world of gamification in online teaching and learning. I'm excited to share with you three powerful levels where gamification can truly elevate our educational outcomes. I'll also reveal three tools that will help you at each level. Get ready for some hands-on learning because we'll see practical examples for each level within my Moodle course featuring H5P's interactive book type. When you go to my site, the link is in the description below, you'll be asked to create an account. It is free and there are no risks. Some basic information is required, but you have full control over your data. Once you have an account, you will have full and free access to all the examples that I build when I make these videos. All right, let's dive into the heart of the matter. Simply put, gamification involves integrating elements commonly found in games, like rewards, challenges, and fun, into non-gaming environments. As educators, our playground is the teaching and learning arena, but gamification isn't limited to classrooms. It extends its reach into various sectors. Think of businesses with customer loyalty programs or workplaces with safety incentives. Even in healthcare, we see how positive health behaviors are incentivized with game-like elements. So why not harness this powerful tool in the realm of education too? Let's break it down. Gamification in teaching and learning operates across three distinct levels. At level one, we introduce a system of badges and leaderboards. It's as straightforward as it sounds and can be seamlessly integrated into most learning management systems, LMSs. In my example Moodle course, for instance, I designed a badge linked to a quiz. Passing the quiz not only earns you a badge, but also a sense of achievement. After all, psychological rewards can be more lasting than material ones. I create my badges in PowerPoint, and I have linked the slide where I created this in one of the descriptions below. All you need for a badge is a PNG file, 67mm by 67mm. My PowerPoint slides help me achieve that. The second thing that you need is criteria for a badge to be awarded. Moodle helps me set that up quickly, and my students are ready to start earning badges. To further enhance engagement, I incorporated the Level Up plugin on my site. This nifty tool allows participants to track their progress and compare their achievements with others on a dynamic leaderboard. It's a game changer, and that pun was intended. Interested in implementing it yourself? Stay tuned for a step-by-step guide on installing and activating this plugin. It's coming right up. If you are a Moodle user with administrative privileges, head over to the link in the description below, download and install the plugin. I installed the free version and will be describing how I used it. The paid-for versions have obviously more functionality. If you have any problems installing or configuring Level Up, please leave a comment below and I'll get some directions to you. Once your plugin is up and running, you need to activate it as a block in the courses where you want learners to experience the leaderboard. With editing on, you need to open the block drawer and activate a new block. Level Up can be set to log events at site level or at course level. On my site, I set it to work at site level. That means a person's position on the leaderboard depends on what was done in all the courses on my site. Once you have Level Up going, open the block drawer, and if you have the right privileges on your site, look for this opportunity to adjust some settings. When you click on settings, this menu will become available to you. I went to points and adjusted the event rule so that students will get 100 experience points for submitting any quiz attempts. Having introduced this rule, Johnny Bravo seems to have become encouraged to make progress up the leaderboard. Level Up comes preloaded with event rules. but you may want to make adjustments. One should have a clear understanding of all the events in all the courses that you want to reward with points. There is a link to a YouTube video in my example course. That video explains some functionality in the Level Up Plus version. Please check it out. At level 2, we take gamification up a notch by introducing puzzles, like crossword puzzles and a variety of other engaging activities. H5P offers word searches, matching games, and even jigsaw puzzles that can spice up any learning experience. In my example course, I opted for the classic crossword puzzle. I put two in the example course. Please try them out. Creating a crossword puzzle is a breeze. Simply select the words you want learners to know and provide them with corresponding clues. Repeat until you have all the words that you want your learners to remember. At level three, we take gamification to the next level by creating an old school video game with the online game development application called Scratch. Scratch is an educational tool developed by MIT and has been instrumental in teaching programming skills to youngsters. In fact, even Harvard incorporates it into its CS50 course, using it to instill algorithmic thinking skills in aspiring computer scientists. I propose to leverage its power to create a game that not only entertains, but also educates. Mastering Scratch is easier than you think. Here's a three-step plan to get you started. I promise you this looks more complicated than it is. Dive into some YouTube tutorials covering the basics of Scratch. I've handpicked a selection of videos and dropped them in the free example course I already mentioned. Peek under the hood of existing Scratch projects. Experiment with tweaking and remixing other creations in the example course. You'll find a link to my Pong Life Stages game ready for your remixing pleasure. When you are ready to craft your masterpiece, ChatGPT is there to assist. Simply describe your game and ChatGPT will generate a helpful outline, a step-by-step guide to arranging Scratch blocks and transforming your vision into reality. I have to admit that I doubted the merit of this current creation of mine, the Pong's Life Stages game. So I've included a link in the example course to a discussion with ChatGPT on my next game, where some randomness in events influences business decisions taken by Joe, our retiree come entrepreneur. This goes beyond the normal branching scenarios that we are used to interact with in H5P. Because interest rates, rent increases, buyer behavior, and luck fluctuates with a measure of randomness to determine whether Joe succeeds or fails. This financial planning game will be the subject of my next video. Remember, the adventure doesn't end here. Subscribe and head to the description below for the link to the example course, where you can explore firsthand the interactive book and gamification elements we've discussed today. Plus, you'll find additional resources to fuel your journey into the world of gamified learning. Don't miss out. Let's embark on this educational odyssey together. See you soon.